friends, in previous presentation, I have already discussed the difference between deterministic algorithm and randomized algorithm, and I have already shown the need of designing randomized algorithms. Basically, we write randomized algorithm for solving optimization problems, and optimization problems are those problems in which we want to maximize or minimize certain function. So here we will be talking about nature-inspired algorithm, and we will show what basic idea we have to use to design these algorithms. So whatever nature-inspired algorithm we want to design, we have to define two functions, and basically these functions are called as operators. So we write operators for implementing exploitation, and we write operators for implementing exploration. So I will show you that why we implement exploitation and exploration in designing functions, in designing these optimization algorithms. So I will show you this one with one example. So let us take this example. So here you can see we have a graph in which we need to identify the maximum value of this function. Although when we apply randomized algorithm, we don't have idea about this graph, but just for explaining, I am showing you this graph. So there are some terms which are related to optimization problem, and when you write nature-inspired algorithm, you must know these points. So first point is we have to define input. So here you can see the input is x, and the input lies between -1 to 2. So that is known as search space. And whatever function we want to maximize or minimize is known as fitness function. So here we want to optimize humps x. So this will be our fitness function, right? So remember, this graph will not be there when you want to write randomized algorithm or nature inspired algorithm. So let us see how can we solve this problem by computer. So there are two methods. Either you have to write deterministic algorithm or you have to write randomized algorithm. So when you are writing deterministic algorithm, the first step is you have to divide this search space into some fixed number of points. And then you have to compare all those points one by one. And actually that comparison has to be done on the basis of fitness function. So when you compare all the solutions, you can find which solution is producing best answer. But how many solutions will be enough to capture global optimal solution? Guess 1024, 2048 or more. So definitely if we increase more number of points, the chances of capturing best solution will be very high. But what will happen when you increase, when you take many points, like 2 to the power 40, 2 to the power 100. So in that case, what you need to do, first you have to identify what are those points. So for that, you need evaluations. So 2 to the power 100 evaluations will be required. Then after calculating those points, you need to calculate the fitness of those points. So again, it needs 2 to the power 100 calculations. And then we have to write procedure for comparing those solutions. So it will almost take 2 to the power 100 comparison. So in total, 2 to the power 200 comparisons will be required almost. So this shows that particular algorithm will take too much time and maybe impractical in certain cases. So what to do? So we can solve these problems by writing nature-inspired algorithm. So these are randomized algorithm. So the idea is very simple. Like deterministic algorithm, we have to divide our search space into fixed number of points. But what we need to do here, we will evaluate only selected points. So all evaluations are not required. So in this way, we can reduce the complexity of the algorithm, and we can get good results in less time. So which point we need to select? So basically, we have to start with some solutions, and then we have to compare those solutions. So, and we have to see which solution is producing good fitness value. So that solution will work as a point for starting our algorithm. Because if you can capture one good solutions, the chances of capturing other good solutions around them will be very high. So that is known as exploitation. But only exploitation is not enough for designing nature inspired algorithm. You need to apply exploration also. So what we have to do with the exploration, so with the help of exploration, you have to check the entire search space. So if you want to identify the global optimal solution for multimodal problems, you have to add both exploitation and exploration. So exploitation will search around the already selected good solutions, and exploration will search other good areas from the entire search space. So in this way, you can solve any problems. So let us take one example algorithm. So that is binary genetic algorithm, and we will see how can we write this algorithm. So why GA? So GA, the theory of genetic algorithm, is based on the theory of natural selection and evolution, which itself support in solving optimization problem. That's why we use this theory for genetic algorithm. So what is there which is important in this theory? So in this theory is based on the theory of Darwin's survival of the fittest, in which it was explained that all species produce their offspring by participating in natural selection and evolution. So what is the important idea in this phenomena? This theory says newly generated children or offspring will have higher fitness as compared to parents. So what will happen actually? When you apply natural selection and evolution, new solutions will be generated, and these new solutions will automatically have higher fitness as compared to the previous solutions. So without doing anything, we can generate those solutions which can produce higher fitness. So if we apply this process generation by generation, we can go to the maximum solution. So how we implement this theory in computer program? So we need to create the same environment, and we need to design operators. So what is binary in binary GA? So first thing is, binary is related to the solution representation. So in binary GA, we represent each solution by a binary number. So how that can be done? So the first thing is, we have to check what is the input search space, and we have to divide that input search space into 2 to the power n number of solutions. For example, we can divide our search space into 16 solution, 32 and 1024. So after dividing search space, each solution can be represented by n bit binary number. So if we are dividing with the search space into 16 solutions, all solutions can be represented as starting from 000 to 1111. So first step in GA is, so because we are mapping natural selection and evolution, so first step will be to create parent population. So we call in program, we call that step is creating initial population. So in this step, we randomly choose 50 solutions from the entire search space. All these solutions are represented in binary. Example, if we are taking 16 solutions, then solution can be represented from apply a randomizer and generate solutions from the whole set. So this is the example of initial population where we have taken only 16 solutions. So after creating parent population, then we have to design offspring. But before that, before applying another operator, we have to convert these binary numbers into the actual number. So for that, we can use this formula. So for example, if our search domain is 0 to 3 and number of points we are taking is 64, then what will be the value of this one? So here we can see x min refers to minimum value of search space, maximum refers to maximum value of this search space, 2 to the power n is how many number of points, so 64. Then we calculate decimal value of this one, so this is 821. So actual value can be calculated by the writing all values in the equation, so it is 1. Another example, so here the search space is same and we want to identify what will be the value of 0101. So here total number of points are not given, but each solution is represented by four bits, so total number of solutions will be 2 to the power 4 and 16. all things will remain same. So you can